What do the dance departments, the music department, and the computing department have in common? That was one of the things we were trying to solve in MINDBEATS 2. This followed on from an earlier project which was much more web technologies based. And what we wanted to do was to do something which it'll be that one. Something which was much more supportive of the creative processes, both of computer scientists and of artists. So one of the challenges of this was to get something which was both artistically valid and also technically achievable. And this was really the challenge which Christopher had in his final year project, to try and work together with us to produce something which would end up with a useful result. One of the objectives we had in mind was the difficulty of international collaboration amongst artists. So scientists tend to have significant amounts of money to do international travel. So a classic scientific activity is to go to some remote location to discuss how to save energy by using significant amounts of air travel to do so. So scientific tourists, conference tourists, are very prevalent. Artistic conference tourists find it much harder to get that sort of funding behind them. So we wanted something which would use latest internet technology to facilitate artistic collaboration and creativity, and do that in a way which did provide some creative imperative for the computing science part of it as well. The aim there was to try and get the computer to be as creative a generator as the artists were themselves, artists in this case being dance and musicians. For pragmatic reasons, we focused primarily on the dance part of this and less on the music part of it, but I'll come back to that a little bit later. Maybe if I move that around, I'm not communicating very well with the machine. The basic technology that we wanted to use was a notation for dance, which is still perhaps a little controversial amongst artists, dancers and choreographers. But it's this Laban notation from the author of this, where you can produce a graphical presentation, a representation of a movement, a dance movement, to put together a series of notations that capture choreography, looking in various a number of dimensions, looking at as their direct, indirect, light, strong, free, bound, sustained, sudden. So by using that notation to represent a choreography of a dance, one can, in principle, provides some notation which then could be used to recreate that. What we wanted to do was to be able to have a machine automatically generate that internal representation of a dancer's movements, and then have the dancer able to manipulate that internal representation in some way so that the part we haven't done yet, the computer could regenerate that and respond to the dancer. So the challenge was the challenge we undertook, or Christopher undertook, was to use a Microsoft Kinect, or in fact two Microsoft Kinects, to be able to capture the movements and then translate those into a Laban effort graph, or a series of effort graphs for a particular movement. With thanks to a very patient and tolerant dancer who supported Chris by performing the appropriate moves or representations of the appropriate moves for him to be able to train the system to see if we could actually capture these accurately, which up to a reasonable point we're able to do. There's still some issues with this, but as you can see here, the computer is monitoring the positions of certain key points on the dancer, so that's an instantaneous representation of the dancer's position. The system will also also generate, as you'll see in a few moments, a representation of the continuous movements of a trace of the continuous movements of the dancer. So you get these little dots moving around as the dancer moves, and then a trace gradually appearing, capturing the continuous trace of the movement. We need a good amount of space for that. So this was the first project that I've known where we had to give the Viva in a dance studio with a dancer. So that made the whole process much more richer experience than the usual final year project. Here you see the two forms of trace. There's an instantaneous capture of the little dots as the kinect is monitoring the movements of certain key points on the body, and the traces of a continuous movement. Then what we needed was a machine learning technique to be able to extract from that the Laban effort graph. And you see, I hope, in a moment, an example of the graph that's actually generated automatically from that dance movement. And I can't remember in my head the that's certainly free, strong, can you? Quick. so it's giving some representation of what that at any one moment what that dancer is doing. The next challenge is to get the dancer to be able to interact with that. So one of there have been similar sorts of things to this in the past. The difficulty with that is that when the dancer wants to change something, they have to walk over to the computer and adjust that. So the bit that's under development at the moment is the 10-foot user interface, so that the just like Tom Cruise did, but without actually touching things and doing this in a much more free way, they can interact with the computer without having to walk over to it or even move from their space. So that's under development. And what we hope is that by September, we will have an even richer demonstration available for Corporeal Computing Conference, which will be held here on the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th of September.